Hi dear fans, friends and subscribers of Cricket Happenings. This is your host Ram welcoming you to your regular edition of the Cricket Happenings show. Now, as you know, in this Cricket Happenings show, we have a sort of a lull in cricket because the T20 World Cup is just over. Everybody are resting, they have gone back home, so they are getting a chance to regain their, regain the equilibrium, I would say, and then get charged up for their whatever the upcoming test series they have, test series or one day or whatever. But as you know, this Cricket Happening show is a daily cricket show, so I will definitely pick up something from cricket and speak to you. I know there are no matches happening, we all know that, but your host Ram never tires about talking about cricket, and here I am once again starting my Cricket Happening show for the day with some news that that one has probably not been able to really keep in touch. The reason being, the whole focus was on the T20 World Cup. Everybody were watching the matches and getting the statistics and a lot of things. So many people would have really missed some cricket news or many things. So I'm just going to have a look at it, glance at it, and just throw it out to you. I hope you all like it, and I hope you all, dear friends and subscribers of Cricket Happenings, have really liked my World Cup, T20 World Cup cricket coverage. Well, so let's start off from, we are starting off from Australia today. The reason being, this is the latest news which is coming in. Now, as you know, there is going to be a tour by the India A team. India A team is going to be touring Australia to take on the Australia A squad. This is a sort of an exchange we had. As you know, Australia A came to India, and now India A is going to Australia to play them. And this is going to be played, the first of one official test match is on July 6th. So they're going to play some test matches, some one-day internationals, and these are going to be played at places like Darwin, Palmerston, Townsville, and Brisbane. And so what Australia has done is really something was unexpected, because Ryan Harris is still, even though he's injured, he's not part of the Australian squad because of his injury. He has been bowling well, as you know, did well against England, and halfway, I mean, we all know how he won the match against South Africa with a limping, in the sense he had a problem and still he came and bowled Australia to victory. One would remember that. So Ryan Harris, I am told that this has come as some unexpected news, especially considering the fact that a cricketer is already still there in international cricket. The Australia A team has plumped for Ryan Harris, and it seems the Pat Howard, the Cricket Australia's general manager, approached them, and he immediately accepted the offer. So Ryan Harris has accepted the offer that has been put to him by the general manager of Cricket Australia, Pat Howard, and he has accepted the role of being the assistant coach of the Australia A team when India A tour team tours there and plays Australia A in the month of July, August. So essentially, Ryan Harris will be partnering the head coach Michael Divinito for the series, not only against India A, also against South Africa A, who are supposed to come to. In fact, as you know, they're going to play a triangular series there. So South Africa A is also coming to Australia. So that should be a great series, according to me. It will really test all the upcoming youngsters who are trying to actually, slowly get their way into the main Indian squad or the Australian squad or the South African squad. So that is some news which was coming in. So I wanted to share that with you. Well, and Australia A team has also been announced. We'll have a look at the team. Which has been announced. Australia have announced a preliminary squad that consists of Jason Bendoff. Now, Jason Bendoff is a bowler who has been performing admirably well in the Sheffield Shield cricket in Australia, and he has taken quite a lot of wickets. I'm told that Jason Behendorf, and there's one more player who has taken a lot of wickets. In fact, I'm just trying to give you the statistics here as to how many wickets did Jason Behendorf and the other bowler took it. Just trying to get you to the statistic here. So these are the two players who have really, really done well in Australia. So right now I don't have the figures with me. And then also the spin department has been protected well, in the sense these two bowlers of spin have done well. Stephen O'Keefe has done well. Cameron Boyce, the leggy, has done well with his, I mean, he has been an improved bowler. He's taken 26 wickets there. So all in all, Jason Behendorf has taken 40 wickets in the in this Australian Sheffield Shield season. Chad Sayers also has 36 wickets, and they also have Kane Richardson and Ben Cutting doing a good job. So definitely, each and every team, when Australia A, India A, and South Africa play, the selectors would be definitely looking at this. The reason being, they'll be looking at which is the team which is, I mean, you know, as you know, the 2015 World Cup would be coming. So definitely they would be keeping an eye on that. And I'm sure all those players who are playing would have to really, really perform well if they ever have to get a chance to get into the main team and, you know, knock on the doors when the World Cup 2015 in Australia and New Zealand would be played. Well, the squad consists of Jason Behendorf, Cameron Boyce, Tom Cooper, Pat Cummins, who is back now, Ben Cutting, Alex Doolan, James Faulkner, Callum Ferguson, Peter Forrest, Josh Hazlewood, who has been doing a great job there. Josh Hazlewood is a very economical bowler. Moises Enriquez, Phil Hughes, Chris Lynn is another good hitter of the ball. Mitchell Marsh, Peter Neville, Steve O'Keefe, Kane Richardson, Chad Sayers, Mitchell Starc, Cameron White, and Sam Whiteman. So that is some news. So I'm still keeping the news as far as Australia is concerned. There is some signing ups have happened. In St. Marcus North, as you know, while the T20 World Cup was going on, he hung up his boots and he retired from Australian cricket. Now, Marcus North was a very exciting player to watch. In the sense, was very attractive when he used to play. And the last one could really think of Marcus North playing was against England in the Ashes, where he scored a century. Now, Derbyshire has taken the opportunity to scalp Marcus North as an overseas player for Derbyshire. So that's the news which is coming in. And another news is that Mark Waugh, who was a very, very attractive batsman to watch, he was really, really a player who was very good on the eye. He also has some very good reflexes, and he was a very, very wonderful player to watch in his time, because he was very, very attractive. And it's just, you know, I can only think of two players who really, really in international cricket have been good to the eye as far as I'm concerned. And I would really pick up two players. For me, the first player who used to make batting look easy and elegant was the former England player and now an English commentator in Sky Sports, David Gower. He was an elegant player, the first one. And the second one that comes to mind is Mark Waugh of Australia. What an attractive player. If at all one talks about elegance, I would plump for my selection would be in this manner. First, I would say David Gower. Second would be Mark Waugh, and third, I would say it would be Brian Lara, the prolific former left-hand batsman. And of this, David Gower and Brian Lara were left-handers, but Mark Waugh was a right-hander. So Mark Waugh, the reason that I'm talking about that is that Mark Waugh, there is a possibility that Mark Waugh may be in the panel of Australian selectors. So that is the news. And one news that we all missed again while the T20 World Cup was going on was the former South African player now, because as you know, Ashwell Prince was a very, very solid batsman, used to play in the middle order for South Africa. He has been also been instrumental in some, not very many victories, but probably one victory I could think of, that was against India or probably Australia, I don't remember. But he was a good player too. He was a he was like a solid rock as far as the middle order was concerned. Couldn't play much matches because he lacked consistency. And Ashwell Prince, the reason that I'm talking about is that there were two players who retired when the T20 World Cup was going on, and that was Australia's Marcus North and South Africa's Ashwell Prince, both these teams. Now I'm going to shift the focus from Australia to India, and the reason being, as you know, India came into the final, they lost to Sri Lanka in the final, and the chairman of selectors is Sandeep Patil. Sandeep Patil is the chairman of selectors, and the reason that I'm talking about that is because the chairman of selectors has very humbly, I would say, has accepted being the chief selector of the Mumbai cricket team. He had resigned as Mumbai selector, so this is something coming as a surprise he has been been selected as the Mumbai Cricket Association secretary. So he's going to be he has been chosen as the chief selector for the Mumbai Cricket Association. Now, Sandeep Patil, as we all know, he hails from Mumbai, my birthplace. Well, and also, the Mumbai selection committee, Mumbai, as you know, didn't do well in the Ranji Trophy, as you know, in 2013. There is a new look selection committee as far as Mumbai are concerned. It is going to be led by Sandeep Patil, as far as the selection committee goes, it would be consisting of Captain Milind Rege, who was a good player, Sanjay Patil, Nishit Shetty, and the three people who go out of the Mumbai selection committee are Deepak Jha. I hear that the last years, the persons who were there in the selection committee before, Deepak Jadhav, Paras Mambre, Rajesh Sutar and Ravi Thakkar have not been included. So that is as far as the Indian news is concerned. Now the last but not the least, we are going to look at England and see what's in store. As far as England are concerned, now the English County Championship has just started, and we all know this is the English County season in England. And it's all started, as you know, we are looking. The reason that I'm talking about that is to tell you that Worcestershire have gone for two New Zealand players. Both are all round. I wouldn't say Mitchell McLennan is a left arm swing bowler, pace and swing bowler. Colin Munro is an all rounder. So they have gone for both these players from New Zealand. And as you know, the other day, there was some sad news as far as England were concerned when Tom Poynton, who actually plays for if I'm not wrong, it's Derbyshire. His father, there was a car crash, Tom Poynton, the talented cricketer, was alive, but he definitely lost his father. Poynton, which was pretty sad, and definitely my condolences to his Tom and his family for such a ghastly incident happening as far as English cricket is concerned. From here, I don't think I would be in a position to, there's not much. As I said, it was just, trying to just catch up with some cricket trivia or some whatever you call it. It's just a matter of filling up this cricket happenings, and I hope I have done my best here, dear friends and subscribers, to fill in the blanks in this cricket happening show. with this particular statement, your host Ram is signing off for the day. Thank you.